Hello everyone, welcome back. We are on the fifth day of activism against gender-based violence, and today I want to talk to you about the after effects and consequences of gender-based violence. With all forms of GBV, we have serious and potentially life-threatening physical, social, and psychological consequences. And today I want to specifically talk to you about the psychological and social consequences of gender-based violence. So for the psychological consequences, we have post-traumatic stress disorder. This is a disorder that a person develops after experiencing a traumatic event, and GBV in itself is very traumatic. So a person is likely to suffer from post-traumatic stress disorder. Number two, we have depression. For depression, a person has frequent flashback of what happened to them. They also have feelings of meaninglessness, worthlessness, and helplessness. So they are likely to suffer from depression. Three, they have fear and anxiety because they do not know what to expect. So they have these insecurities, and they do not want to go out because they are afraid of what may happen to them. And then number four, we have self-blame, self-hatred, and a low self-esteem. So they will they're likely to feel very bad about themselves because of the incidents that happened to them, which could lead to suicidal ideations and even the behavior itself. So they are likely to take away their lives, and also it could lead to serious chronic mental health illness. The social consequences of gender-based violence are very serious because the society tends to blame a person who's been affected, yet it's not their fault. And this is very sad because it leads to a negative impact on the mental health of a person. A person is likely to experience social stigma, social isolation and rejection, and they blame themselves, and even they take away their lives. So it is very sad. We need to support any person who has gone through gender-based violence. We need to be there for them. We need to hold their hands and educate them and walk with them the journey of healing, so that they can be able to heal. There is no way a person who has gone through gender-based violence will heal when they're facing all this stigma around GBV, the stigma in the society, and the rejection and hatred. So we need to work with them, we need to support them, and we need to be there for them. And also the society needs to be educated that it's not anyone's fault to be a victim of gender-based violence. And nobody chooses, it just happens, and it can happen to anyone. So we need to be very, very supportive, and we need to be to educate others as well, so that they can learn that GBV is just it's just unfortunate. So let us be there for everyone, let us support them, and let us spread the news that together we can end gender-based violence. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope it has been helpful, and I hope it has also been educative. So let us all hold hands and end gender-based violence. So remember to subscribe, share, like, and comment. Until next time, bye bye.